So we are studying symmetrical component to analyze the unbalanced system, okay, which have a different voltage and current of each phase. That's why it required to analyze the each phase separately, okay, and that is a time consuming, okay, and cumbersome approach. So to make efficient approach, we have to introduce symmetrical component. Okay, so what are the symmetrical component? Any unbalanced system, suppose you have any unbalanced set of voltages or currents, you can break up into three set of balanced voltages and current. In that, two phases are balanced phasor and one is cophasor. Okay, so suppose you have a, let us consider you have one three phase voltage. Suppose this is a BA, okay, this is BB voltage, okay, and this one is BC voltage. Okay, these voltages are unbalanced. How do I know unbalanced voltage? Simply by seeing their magnitude. Okay, so here you can see the magnitude of BA. Okay, what is the magnitude? Magnitude is nothing but the phasor length of the voltage or current is called magnitude. Okay, so you can see here BA is not equal to BB, is not equal to BC. Okay, that's why these three voltages are unbalanced. And second thing is that each means all phases are displaced 120 degree apart. Okay, so these two conditions we have to check for the balanced of the three phase system. Okay, if any condition violates, then that system is not balanced. So to solve this or to analyze this system, we have to break this system into three set of balanced voltages, because these are the voltages. That's why we break up into three set of balanced voltages. If there is current, then we have to break up into three set of balanced currents. Okay, so this is unbalanced voltage. So we can break up into three set of balanced voltages. Okay, so now we break. Okay, so first voltage is positive sequence. Okay, so since positive, why we are saying positive sequence? Because their sequence is similar to the supply sequence. Okay, and supply is balanced. Okay, in that case their sequence is same. So this is, this dotted line represent the reference. Okay, from reference point you can see there your voltage is leading, this voltage is lagging, this voltage is leading. Okay, by some angle, we don't know what is the angle. Okay, so we have to break up this set of this unbalanced set of voltages into three set of balanced voltages. Okay, so this is a reference. I am assuming reference line. Okay, continuous. Okay, for all three phases. Okay, so let, this is the reference. Okay, so first is BA. Okay, I am assuming our BA voltage is like this, BA1. Okay, and it is lagging by 120 degree. BV1. Okay, so this is a, suppose this one is BV1. Okay, and their phase length is same as this. Okay, so I'm assuming this one is BV1. Okay, similarly this one is BC1. Okay, and their voltages are same. This length, this length, this length, all three phasor length are same. Okay, and their angle is 120 degree. Okay, means this angle is 120 degree. This angle is also 120 degree. This angle is also 120 degree. Okay, so that you have to keep. Okay, before observing positive phase sequence. So positive phase sequence is balanced. Then you have add negative sequence. Okay, so you can just put here some negative sequence. Okay, let BA2 is here. Okay, then 120 degree from this, let this is B C2 and this one is B V2. Okay, so these three phasor is also having same length and their displacement, phase displacement is 120 degree apart. Okay, now another phasor I am assuming, that is zero sequence. Okay, so I am assuming that your zero sequence is displaced by some angle from the reference. Okay, so this is BA0, same length BB0 and same length phasor BC0. Okay, so all three phasor have same length. Okay, so this is BC0, this is BB0, this is BA0. So these are the zero sequence. Okay, if I am adding up this plus this, then I am getting this voltage. Okay, so this is what, this is unbalanced voltage, this is unbalanced, this is positive sequence, this is balanced, this is negative sequence, this is also balanced, and this is cophasor. So this is called zero sequence, because you can see the phase displacement between BA0, BB, VC0. Okay, all three zero sequence voltage are away, zero phase displacement. Here 120, here 120. Okay, that's why their sequence is this one. This is, this one is what, clockwise, and this is anti-clockwise. Okay, that's why this is negative, this is positive. So if I want to add these three phasors in phasor form, okay, then how can I add up? Okay, if suppose we have a displacement phasor, okay, this is reference. Okay, this is reference line. From there our zero sequence phasor is this. Okay, so this is same for all three phases, it will not change, its a magnitude is fixed. Okay, that's why this is BA0. Okay, so this phasor will have a BA0 length. Okay, you can see the here magnitude of BA0 equal to magnitude of BB0 equal to magnitude of C0. Okay, means all three zero sequence voltages have a same magnitude. So I am writing this BA0. Okay, similarly this is also BB0, this is also BC0. Now I plot the positive sequence. Okay, if I plot here positive sequence, then what is the positive sequence? Positive sequence, it means this voltage is to this direction. Okay, this is BA1. Okay, now 120 degree. Okay, so this is what, BB1. Okay, then BC1. Okay, so this is what, BC1. Okay, so these three positive sequence voltage I have drawn. Okay, this one. Okay, now we have to draw negative sequences. Okay, so you can see negative sequence, where is negative sequence? Negative sequence is this. Okay, so their phasor is coming to this direction. Okay, so I, you know that if in phasor addition you can parallelly shift phasor anywhere. Okay, you can parallelly shift this vector anywhere in parallel position. Okay, and you can also change its direction by placing negative sign. Okay, so two operation you have to know the phasor. First operation is that you can parallelly shift phasor anywhere. Okay, in parallel you can shift parallelly. Okay, and second one, you can reverse the direction of phasor by placing negative sign in front of the their vector or magnitude. Okay, so if I want to place negative BA1, then just opposite it. Okay, 180 degree face reversal. Okay. So I can place parallel to this. This is in this direction. So I can also place BA2 in this direction. This is what BA2. Okay. Then this is what BA0. So what is BA? BA is this. Okay. You can see BA is this one. This is what BA. Okay. So BA is nothing but BA0 plus BA1 plus BA2. Okay. Similarly, what is BV? Okay. So for BV, BV1 or BA0. So you can see this is BA0, this is BA1. What is B? B2. So BV2, you can see this is in up direction. Okay. Upper direction. So parallel, this is little bit this direction. Okay. You can see 120 degree. This is like this. Okay. So their angle is 120 degree. This is also 120. This is also 120. Okay. So you can better way visualize. Okay. This angle is very less. So this is, you can see, this is BA2. Okay. This angle is 120. This is also 120. This is also 120. So what is BA2? Okay, BA2 is in this direction. Now we want to find BB. Okay, this measure. Okay. So this is what BA0 is this, BA1 this. Now what is BV2? BV2 is this. So I can just put this parallel to this line. This line. Okay. This is BV2. Okay. So you are getting another measure. That is BA0, or we can say BB0 plus BB1 plus BB2. So this is the phase angle. Okay. Which is BB. Okay. Because this is BA0 is same as BB0. Okay. So this is BA1, this is BB2. Okay. Similarly, you can also add up for phase BC. So BC, you have broken up into BC1, BC2 and BC0. So BC0 and BA0 is same and BC1 this. Now what is BC2? BC2 is in this direction. So I can place parallel to this at this tip. Okay. So if I place parallel to this, then this is BC2. Okay. So what is BC? BC is simply from origin. Okay. This is our origin from this point. So this is a BC. Okay. So you can see BA, BV, BC all are in same place. BC in the BA in this direction, you can see BA in this direction. BA is also in this direction. BV is in this direction. BV is in this direction. Okay. You can see this. Okay. Okay. So this is BV, okay? You can see, so all three phases, BA, BA, BV, BV, BC, BC, okay? These are parallel, okay? Same as this. And this is broken up into three set of balance phases, okay? So now, this is the phasor analysis of three phase symmetrical components. Okay. So this is clear. I think it is clear to all of you. Okay. Now we have to analyze the phasor analysis. Okay. So the phasor analysis done by one of the operator. Okay. That is operator of symmetrical component. Because these three, there are three components. So if you are writing, so you are getting 9 variables, okay? But initially there are 3 variables. So we have to convert into 9 into 3 variables. This we have discussed in previous class. So now let me see the properties of the alpha operator, okay? So you already know alpha can be written as 1 angle 120 degree. This can also be written as 1 e to the power j 120 degree. And this is can also 1 e to the power j 2 pi by 3. Okay. In that way, you can write this. Okay. And if you are writing this, then you can write this is angle, and by Euler property, angle of cos and this angle of theta, you can write cos theta cos 120 plus j sin theta. So sin 120. You know the value of cos 120. Okay. So this is 1. If you multiply 1 with any number, the number itself. So this is cos 120 is minus 1 by 2, and this is sin 120 is j under root 3 by 2. I think this you know. Okay. So if you are writing in fraction, this is 0.5 plus j 0.866. Okay. So this value you know. Okay. Now if I want to find the alpha conjugate, then simply you place one angle 120 degree. If you will take conjugate, then magnitude conjugate is magnitude itself, and angle is its a sign will change. Okay, so this is minus 120 degree. Okay, so you can see if I put minus 120 degree, then angle is minus 120 degree. Okay, so this is nothing but if there is you know the coordinate system. This is a reference. If angle is 120 degree here. Okay, this is 120 degree. Then you can see their angle, just its image. Okay, so this is minus 120 degree. So you can see this one. This is, suppose this is alpha. Okay, this is alpha. Then this is what alpha conjugate, or you can say this is also from here. You can see this angle is 240. So this is alpha square also. So I can write this also as a angle 1, angle 240. Okay, because if you are measuring from this point, then this angle is 240. Okay, so I can also write this angle 240. Okay, so I can write this e to the power j 120 ka whole square. So this is nothing but alpha square. So this is also alpha square. Okay, these identity you have to remember. Okay, we will use in problems. Okay, now if you want to find what is alpha cube, so you can write alpha cube. What is the alpha cube? If you place here e to the 1 e to the power j 120 degree, if you are cube it, then this is 1 e to the power j 360, and this you can write e to the power 360 means you are returning to origin. So its a magnitude is 1. Okay, so this is also very important identity. If somebody asks what is alpha to the power 4, so you can write alpha cube into alpha. So this is alpha, and alpha we know this is minus 0.5 plus j 0.866. Okay, you can change sign here. Because this is negative, so this is also negative. Okay. So this is about the identities of alpha. Okay. Now, how do I represent alpha on phasor plane? Okay. So we have to represent alpha on the phasor. Okay. So now let us represent alpha on a phasor plane. Okay. Representation of alpha on the phasor. Okay, so alpha is what? One angle 120 degree. Okay, so suppose this is our reference, then you can represent alpha at 120 degree. Okay, so this is alpha. Okay, now this is what? This is alpha to the power 0. Okay, so this is what alpha to the power 0 means, one angle 0, this is 1 angle 120 degree. This is positive angle, so this is positive 120 degree. Okay, positive 120 degree. Okay, similarly if you are taking its a conjugate. Okay, so this is what conjugate or square. This is alpha square. From here you can see this is 120, this is also 120, So this is 1 angle 240, or this is also equal to alpha conjugate. Okay, and you have proved it right now. Just before, this is also equal to alpha cube. Okay, so you can easily identify this is alpha cube. Okay, this is alpha. This is alpha square or alpha conjugate. Okay. Now, if you want to find minus one, so what is minus one? Just opposite of this. This is one phasor. Okay, this is also one phasor. If you opposite this phasor, okay, with the same length, one magnitude, then you are getting this one. Here is minus one, and this is minus alpha cube. I have told you, you can reverse the direction of phasor by placing negative sign in front of the value of that phasor length. Okay, so this is this. Similarly, you can write minus alpha. Minus alpha is just opposite of this. So this is what? Minus alpha. Okay. Similarly, minus alpha square. This is what? Minus alpha square. Or minus alpha conjugate. Okay, in that way. So these are the things. So the if you see all these, this phasor, this phasor, this phasor, all these phasor have a same length alpha. Okay, so if you join it, they will have a same length. Or any, you know, if magnitude is fixed and that magnitude you will rotate, then you are getting a circle form. Okay, so this is circle form formulation, just like a circle. Okay, so I am just representing this. Don't mind, this is circle. Okay, my drawing is not so good. So this is a circle form. Okay, now if you want to find what is alpha plus minus alpha conjugate or alpha minus alpha square, then simply you phasor sum it. Okay, how do I do phasor sum? Just place parallel to this at the tip of this, and similarly this phasor parallel to this at this tip, then you are getting some resultant. Okay, so how do I get resultant? Suppose I want to find 1 minus alpha. Okay, so 1 is this, this value is 1 angle 0, and this is minus alpha. So I can place there parallel to the this phasor, I placing parallel to this. Okay, that is called parallelogram method. Okay, so I'm placing parallel to the same length of this. Okay, similarly parallel to this, I placing a one parallel vector here. Okay, so this is parallel to this. So this is what? 1 minus alpha. Similarly, you can find other, okay, modified values like 1 plus 1 minus alpha square. Okay, so 1 is this value and minus alpha is this. Okay, so we have to place parallel to this. Okay, parallel to this vector, place at the tip of another vector. Okay, another vector is this. So this is what? This is parallel to this. Okay, and parallel to this at this. So this is what? This is 1 minus alpha square or 1 minus alpha conjugate. Okay, similarly you can formulate other operators and write their combinations. Okay, so this is your homework. Please put 1 minus minus 1 plus alpha square, alpha minus alpha square, and alpha square minus alpha. Okay, similarly this, then you are getting some other operated circle. Okay, so this is your homework. Please go through it.